Her blistering recent displays might have gotten you excited for what's next, but Sabina Mazo says hold off on calls for stage upgrades. The numbers alone show that Mazo boasts an undefeated, but somewhat shy record of 4 professional MMA bouts. But the how many isn't the key here, as much as the how. In her last 2 outings, both under the LFA banner, Mazo dispatched her opponents in the first round with highlight reel head kick knockouts. Given there have been fighters who made it to the octagon with less buzz, and the fact that the UFC is currently starting to build its women's flyweight roster, it wouldn't be a stretch to imagine the Colombian queen making the transition to the big stage soon. But after dispatching Lindsay Williams 12 at last week's LFA 23, Mazo 40 says not so fast. I want to gain more experience and be a little more prepared before making another step, Mazo told Majunkie Radio. Because I feel all right in this moment. I feel like it's the moment where I can change a lot of things in my game. And I still don't feel, like, ready to step to the UFC and make the difference. Not just being a good fighter, but really making the difference between all of them. While no one can blame a fighter for making the step up in competition, and, consequently, in pay, by migrating to big players like the UFC or Bellator, there's also something commendable about Mazo's decision to keep honing her skills before jumping into the shark tank. But even as she makes her way up, the Kings MMA fighter is already getting to enjoy a bit of fame that a lot of her peers don't. Both of her vicious head kick knockouts gained some viral traction, which meant some serious attention for the 20-year-old, both in her current home in the US and in her native Colombia. While for some the added eyeballs can prove to be a bit much, Mazo welcomes the chance to prove just how far she's come. They're super happy in Colombia, Mazo said. A lot of people didn't really believe in me. They were kind of thinking I was crazy, because the sport is not as popular as it is over here in the United States. So, you know, a lot of people were like, I mean, she is good, but they didn't believe I had a future in this. So it really makes me happy that I can prove a lot of people that really didn't think I could do it. It's just the beginning. And I'm really proud I can really show everyone, not only in Colombia, but all over the world, that we can do it. As for how these head kicks keep coming by, well, it requires some studying and analyzing of her opponent's movement. It requires some patience. But, at the end of the day, there's this other thing. It just comes naturally, you know, Mazo said. To hear more from Mazo, check out the video above. And for more on upcoming MMA schedule, check out the MMA Rumor section of the site. Majunkie Radio broadcasts Monday free day at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, 10 a.m. PT, live from Mandalay Bay Resort Casino's Race Sports Book. The show is hosted by gorgeous George Garcia and producer Brian Goes Garcia. For more information, or to download past episodes, go to www.majunkie.com radio.